Welcome to the Hustler's Guide to Flow. I'm your host, Marcia Miyake, and I'm taking you into the minds of some of the most incredible leaders in the medical, research, business, and yes, even spiritual fields to equip you with powerful insights and practical strategies to level up in business and in life. The next level version of yourself starts now. Welcome back to another episode, my loves. So 2 days ago, it was my birthday. I'm 36. And it was so funny. Dan says a lot of really funny things like in passing, and he doesn't, like, he really says things so innocently. And sometimes I just look at him and I burst out laughing. And we have like an inside joke where I always say, I'm going to tell Natty. So when he says something offensive, and he's not even aware that it's offensive, I'm always like, I'm going to tell Natty, who's his sister. So he was like, oh my God, 36, babe, like home stretch to 40 or something along those lines. And I looked at him like, oh my God, babe, what? So anyway, but you know what? I used to resist aging in my 20s. Like, I literally hated the idea of it. Like, I remember thinking that 22 was old. And then when I was 22, I thought, oh my God, 26 is old. And then 30 was like super old. And now I'm just like, I am really happy to be aging, if that makes sense. Like, I love it. I feel so much better now than I did in my 20s, and I'm embracing it. Obviously, I, you know, want to take care of myself, but there isn't this feeling of resistance that I had in my 20s. So I'm really enjoying it. Okay, let's get into this episode. So I wanted to talk about some strong indicators or some signals or signs about when you should be investing in your healing. Sometimes we wait for a rock bottom or some huge sign or something horrible happening in our lives before we're like, okay, I need to make a change. I need to heal my past. And my whole thing is, don't wait for it to be so painful, guys. You really don't have to. There's a lot of little signs along the way. You know, we're always getting signals about what we should be doing. And if we're paying attention, we don't need to wait for a disaster to happen in our lives to really start making some powerful moves. So the number one thing is, if you keep experiencing the same challenges in your health, relationship, business, prosperity, or whatever. So if you keep attracting the same experiences, no matter what you do, and you feel like you've tried different things, but you still keep attracting the same situations, or you can't make push through, for example, with your health, like if you have tried different diets and different plans and you can't release the weight that you need to or bring your weight up to a healthy and strong level, that could be a sign that you need to do some healing work. Same with your relationships. If you've tried doing all these different things and you're trying to date different people, but you know, you still encounter the same challenges, that right there could also be a sign that you need to do some healing work. Okay. So number two is kind of related to number one. And that's when you're actually taking all the right action and you're doing all the right things, but you can't break through to the next level in one or all areas of your life. This is especially true with our careers and our business, where you can hire an amazing business coach and you can, you know, do all the right things at your job to get a promotion, but you're like not breaking through. There could be some subconscious blocks there and some limiting beliefs that you're not really aware of that are actually holding you back. Okay, number three is kind of the opposite of that. So when you've achieved all the external success and received the accolades and you still feel unfulfilled. Okay. So a lot of the times we think that when we arrive at the destination, like when we have the partner or the career or the babies or the money, that we're going to feel fulfilled. But we need to really do the work to feel fulfilled now, because there is nothing more disappointing than like crushing all your goals and then being like, I feel no different. So from my perspective is, they need to be done in tandem. So advancing your career and doing that inner work should be done at once, because when you get to that destination, like when you achieve those business goals and when you're crushing it, you're also going to feel
deeply fulfilled and at peace. And that is, from my perspective, is true success. Okay, so number four, when there are aspects of your past that you can't seem to get over and people you just can't bring yourself to forgive. Okay, that's like a pretty obvious one, because here's the thing, like I understand if traumatic things happen to you in your past. I get it. I have been there. I have experienced quite a bit of trauma myself. And what I will say to you is that anger that you are harboring towards the person who did you wrong or the situation that did you wrong, you are impacting the chemistry in your body. You are polluting your body with the toxins. So even though they've done you wrong, you are choosing to forgive them for yourself, not for them. There is such a freeing experience when you choose to forgive someone. And when you forgive your past, you can really step into your power. Okay, number five. When you seem to keep attracting the same people and situations that make you feel disempowered. Okay, I see this a lot. So we, especially for dating as women, we seem to attract the same guy. And that's because there's some wounding there. And if you haven't gone back and cleared that, you will continue to attract the same relationship, same situation that make you feel like people don't respect your boundaries, people don't respect you, you don't have a voice, etc. Okay, number six, when you can see yourself projecting your trauma on others, especially your children. Okay, so this is a huge one. When I talk about projecting trauma on our children, this can be a really wide range of things, from vicariously living through them. So like trying to put your dreams on them, putting too much pressure on them, to being overly controlling or projecting your insecurities on them. Now, this is a tough one because most people are not aware that they're doing it because it seems so natural. It seems so natural because your parents did it to you. So it requires a high level of self-awareness to know that you are doing this, to know that you are, you know, in essence, traumatizing your child because you haven't cleared up your past traumas, okay? But number seven is linked to that one as well. And that's when you feel an underlying emotion of shame. So some of us can't recognize how much we are projecting on others, but we can feel the underlying emotion of shame. So sometimes if we lose our stuff on our kids, or we get into a fight with someone and we respond in not at a high level, we're embarrassed after. There's an underlying emotion of shame. You become ashamed of who you are. And, you know, so if you can't recognize exactly how you're projecting on others, that emotion of shame is a pretty good indicator of that. If you feel a lot of shame around your relationships and how you treat others, that's a really strong indication there that you need to do some healing work. Okay, and number eight, when you feel unable to fully express who you are. Now, this is really common. How many of us really grew up in a home or in an environment where this was really encouraged, like where we were seen and recognized for who we are and not judged in any way or we didn't feel judged in any way? You know, like our parents were doing their best from their level of consciousness, but at that time, they didn't have... Most of our parents didn't have access to this knowledge that we have now. And so a lot of times they projected on us, shamed us, and we made that about us, and we made that, I can't fully express who I am, or who I am at my core is wrong, or who I am at my core is not good enough. So when you have that underlying belief in your subconscious, like it's really effing hard to show up in this world powerfully. So if you feel like you want to do these things, you want to make these moves, you want to be more visible, you want to get out there and you have a message, but something is holding you back, that's a really big indicator that you need to do some healing work. Number nine is when you have unexplained fears and phobia. This is a big one because, you know, sometimes we say, I'm fearful of this. I don't really know why, or we try to link it to our childhood or et cetera. But sometimes we actually don't have a linear or clear explanation as to how we have these fears. Again, this could be something in the subconscious, and that's a really big indicator of needing to do some healing work, because you don't have to be a victim to anything, especially your own fears. And so if you have the courage to own that and say, hey, I've got these fears and I don't even know where they freaking come from, but I'm ready to do that deep work, then you're going to have some powerful breakthroughs. And number 10, and I think this is the one we should all be aiming for, is when you just feel ready to take your life to the next level, right? So I always say, like, for you to get to the next level, you need to elevate yourself, like as in who you are. And it's not that we are becoming someone new, but more so that we are removing who we are not. We are removing the layers of judgment that we put on ourselves. We are removing the layers of expectation that our parents or society put on us. We are just ready to take ourselves to the next level, but as who we truly were when we were born, as we came into this world as pure consciousness. We want to go back to that level of pure love and then really step into that powerfully. So I always say, please don't wait to fall on your face. Like I have, that's kind of been my track record in the past, where I would wait for something like so traumatic to happen before I would be like, okay, things need to change. You don't need to do it like that. Like I know us humans love drama, but don't do it to yourself. If you are feeling in this moment, like, you know, my life's pretty good, but like, I feel like I could be doing better. Like I want to be doing better. Then you know what, like reach out to me, send me an email, DM me, you know, we can have a conversation to see if, you know, how we can support you. Also definitely join my Facebook group. We do a lot of free training in there. And just remember, like you have the power to change your life. Only you do. And it starts with a decision. So make that decision today that you deserve more and you can step into that unapologetically.
Okay, guys, I hope you got some powerful takeaways from this episode. If so, please share it with someone. And if you haven't done so already, please review and subscribe, as it helps us to spread our message of inspiration. Sending you all so much love, and I'll see you on the next episode of The Hustler's Guide to Flow.